Welcome back to Assassin's Creed 3 Remastered. Time to head on open seas. French involvement. There's some peg leg. The Mad Doctor's castle. So there's two more pieces of the map to find. Welcome to Jamaica. What I'll find inside here. These missions have had some tricky synced optional objectives.
Joseph Palmer retired to Jamaica, somewhere around this castle. Faulkner said the scroll would likely have ended up in Lord Lewis Hutchinson's private museum. This place has seen much evil.
Much evil, you say? Okay.
Hutchinson's personal museum. Kid's scroll must be here somewhere.
Okay, broken display case. A blood stain. Broken vase.
The shot must have come from the balcony.
All right, gonna find the way up. Oh. Okay. I'm gonna try again. Okay, so time limit to get up there of 1 minute. Huh.
The killer must have chased his prey, but through where?
Okay, the mask.
The mechanism of the mask is broken.
A missing musket.
I do not understand how anyone could live here. Small wonder Hutchinson went mad. This place feels mad.
When? How do I get out of here? Ah, there we go.
This place has seen much evil. There must be some clues around that can help me with this. The other clocks might tell me something. He must have written the answer somewhere. There must be some clues around that can help me with this. Close to a tree kissed by fire.
I may not have gotten all the chests, but I don't think they contain anything other than coin, and I have plenty of that. I'm going to upgrade the ship. Okay, into the north. 1770.
Faulkner's guess better be right. Why anyone would believe the Northwest Passage exists is beyond me.
Okay, then.
The Octavius. Hendrik Vanderhall's first and last captaincy.
I get up there. Okay, made it. Some coin. Well, it's over there, isn't it? I don't know why Connor fell into the water then. I just wanted them to fall down.
Hendrik Vanderhall. Captain Kidd's quartermaster turned captain himself. The path you sought never existed, Hendrik. I hope your suffering was short. I need to get out of this thing. I must get out! That was close. Must not get caught in here. I must not get caught in here. Not much time. And abreast the rock that doesn't fit.
Okay, the ghost ship.
What'd you make of it?
They all appear to be parts of the same piece of leather. It lies under the eagle's bed, near the wolf's abode, close to a tree kissed by fire, and abreast the rock that does not fit, and a route to an island. The symbols remain elusive.
That's Oak Island. I've sailed past it 50 times. A forgettable isle, to say the least.
The location seems to be the easy part.
Aye. And we'll be waiting for you the moment you want to get after it.
You actually found something?
Oak Island.
I'm a little on edge, Captain. The prospect of Captain Kidd's treasure and the mysteries that lie with it have me a trifle spooked.
Stay your anxiety. It is likely only treasure.
I thought the same thing, but considering what the man went through to hide it, I'm not so sure.
We'll see.
All those scrolls lead us to the belly of this remote island. Awful out of the way, Captain. What was Kidd hiding, for cripe's sake?
I do not know, but I am intrigued to find out.
Remember what was written. Close to a tree kissed by fire, near the wolf's abode, under the eagle's bed and the rock that does not fit. Whatever that means. Do you think there might be landmarks?
Possibly.
That is it. Got it. That is it. There. There. Got it. Got it. Done. I know where it is.
How in the... You figured it out.
Oh, that's why you're the captain.
Wolves on us, Captain! Bloody wolves on us, Captain!
Well, I felt I had pressed the key properly there, but apparently not.
Bloody wolves on us, Captain!
One down. Run away, Wolfie. Come on. Oh, damn it.
Bloody wolves on us, Captain!
Fucking wolves, really. Well, and the objective to not kill use ranged weapons. I don't get it. I pressed the damn button and yet it doesn't register within the time frame. Sometimes. That's two. Damn it.
Bloody wolves on us, Captain.
Okay. Another one. Can't you shoot them?
Yama.
That's a bloody big piece of stone. Any ideas?
Perhaps some gunpowder would move it.
A nice big explosion, eh? Might do the job. We'll do well to scare away any more blasted wolves, that's for certain. That ought to be enough.
Thank you.
what Captain Kidd suffered over for so long. Astonishing.
What the hell is this?
There he is!
Thought we lost you there for a moment, Captain. Are you all right?
Yes. I think so.
What happened down there? What did you find? That's it. A single gold coin. There was nothing else. Was the cash pilfered already? Ah!
What the devil?
I do not know how it works, but I now understand why Kidd valued it so.
Okay, and how is this gonna help me? I mean, I did all of this work for a piece of Eden, okay? And how does this help me? Oh, great!
It's a curious little piece, isn't it? Well, I've worked my incredible and bottomless magic, and that little thing is, in fact, of first civilization origin. It seems they use them as personal shields. It gives off a rather powerful electromagnetic field, explains its aversion to metal, also explains why Kidd's legend tells of him being invincible. Having that trinket in your pocket would easily bend a musket ball's trajectory. Nifty little thing, really. Anyway, just thought you want to know. Please do carry on.
Well, I guess that was useful. Mainly, I'll worry about this later. All right, naval outfit acquired. Let's go. Let's see what this mission is about. The Caribbean Sea.
Our charge, Captain. The Belladonna, under Rodrigo Hortalis and Company. She appears Spanish for all intents and purposes, but rest assured she's a French vessel.
French are bringing in a boatload of powder and guns for old Georgie and his patriots. Some colonial boats were supposed to escort her up the coast, but they left her behind. She's been waiting ever since.
We will make sure Washington gets what he is expecting.
Where is le capitaine?
I am the captain.
You are late!
We came as quickly as the wind allowed.
Too slow!
What happened to your escort?
Le Randolph started with us, then departed without warning. Typique! This is why le lieutenant insisted I come aboard. Partons!
We'll go when we're good and bloody ready.
What?
The Atlantic is a dangerous place for a lone ship, especially one laden with such desirable stock. You must be glad to see us.
Boff.
It is hot here. My lieutenant is not excited for the cold of the north.
Is this man being serious?
Keep a sharp eye, Mr. Faulkner. Anybody searching for the Belladonna could be upon us in an instant with this fog.
Aye, Captain. I've got a monkey's fist in me gut.
You're on us, Captain!
Ah! The power of the French Navy is clear!
They picked the wrong ship to pirate. Why in God's name are the English here in such force?
I do not know, but we must get the Belladonna out of this fog.
Another wreck for the deep!
Oh, this is gonna be a problem.
The Belladonna's main mast is down, Capitaine! We must stick close to her!
Bloody hell! Pummel that Leviathan!
No! Before her, I must know how the English knew about the Belladonna.
We take her apart!
eyes, men!
Bald her!
How does the British command know about the Belladonna?
British command knows nothing of this.
Then how are you here?
We were led here by a patriot, Nicholas Biddle.
Who does Biddle work for?
Oh, I think you know. Assassin.
What did the captain tell you?
Nicholas Biddle led them here. He said... The Randolph.
The Randolph? Beat to quarters!
Belay that order!
He is putting us to his rudder. We cannot leave the Belladonna undefended.
But sir!
She is incapacitated and vulnerable. Let him go. We will see each other again soon.
Well, isn't that wonderful? Okay, fiddle.
You see the catch fired, Captain!
Anything, Captain?
Due north of here.
Well, I guess we'll figure out what we're dealing with. I certainly have the ship capable of dealing with anything that Biddle might have, seeing as it's fully upgraded, almost.
What's that weasel up to? Sheet anchor to windward, Captain. You can be sure he's got something up his sleeve.
Let's pursue then. Man of wars?
It's a bloody armada. I knew he was up to something. And he's turned to fight us. We're in it now, Captain.
Let's fight then.
So we fight, Mr. Faulkner. Board the Randolph. Sink the rest.
Well, I say,
bring down her.
Okay.
It's a bloody armada. I knew he was up to something. And he's turned to fight us. We're in it now, Captain.
So we fight, Mr. Faulkner. Board the Randolph. Sink the rest.
Down our
men.
It's a bloody armada. I knew he was up to something. And he's turned to fight us. We're in it now, Captain.
So we fight, Mr. Faulkner. Board the Randolph. Sink the rest.
Prepare to board. Biddle is mine.
All right, Bill. You're gonna be my victim this day.
Let's do this. Bring her close.
Two arms. Two arms.
Man the swivels. Cover from the quarter deck.
Secure the aft line. Tie off the bow.
Sense of justice is pathetic. You should have never set foot outside your little village. Tenacious? Smart. Pity I have to kill you. Kenway will reward me. Come on, you savage. Give me your best.
Thank you.
sense of justice is pathetic. You should have never set foot outside your little village.
It's because I took that fire damage at the start. Alright, let's try again.
Your reign over the colonial coast has come to an end.
Is that why you hunted me? Because you thought me an enemy to the cause? You're every bit the fool I was told.
You brought pain and suffering upon innocent people for nothing but personal gain.
Pain. Suffering. I set them free. Weeded out the dissenters and empowered the patriots. So what if I was named admiral? The revolution needs one, and I was the best man for the job. The only man. If not for me, the Continental Navy would remain but a handful of rafts. For all your vision, you assassins are blind to the truth.
Enough.
Wait. Let the Randolph die with me. Don't take her as a prize. Please. Please. I want no quarter. Just to sink with my ship.
I can't believe you mean to leave the Randolph. She's a mighty vessel, Captain, and one of Biddle. You show him mercy in the face of...
I guess that's that, then. Tad overdramatic, if you ask me. Still, a waste of a formidable ship. How's about a cheer for the boys, then, eh?
Victory for the Akita! For her glory! Hip, hip, hurrah!
Hurrah! Hurrah!
Hurrah!
Hurrah!
Hurrah!
I've been the Wild Rover for many a year, and I've spent all my money on whiskey and beer.
Okay, then. I just feel like killing people that I shouldn't be killing. Though I suppose if you're gonna fight someone, you might as well feel sympathetic towards them. See, this is one of the things that I dislike about Assassin's Creed, right? Is that you are forced to kill these guys, which I wouldn't want to do it. I mean, I guess Odyssey is different in this respect. I should probably play that, really. Because it does give you choices that you have. Let me see what outfits there are. Now, I admit, I like how this outfit looks, except the way, well, the way it looks on his face. That's the only real major issue here. I might get that. Anyway, cosine, Senya.